I would like to invite Sardar Hamza Khan from University of Azad Jammu and Kashmir, Muzaffarabad, for speech. Sardar Hamza Khan.
Behold, Mr. President, sir, you see brutality. Behold, Mr. President, so you can witness ferocity. And behold, for ladies and gentlemen, I will walk you through the corridors of Maqbooza, Jammu and Kashmir. My lord, I learned how to walk. I learned how to talk. I have dreams, I have wishes. I was a young bird about to fly. But wait. Yes, wait. Wait, because you have to listen what actually happened, how this so-called brutal world put me to death. Yes, Your Honor, yes, I'm the innocent soul of district Jammu who was molested, gang-raped and abducted by Indian Army soldiers. I was hardly 13 years old when ruthlessly killed in an Indian colony, but international community is silent. You were silent and you remained silent. Everyone was silent. October 2, 2016. The darkest day, the toughest day. The darkest day for millions of families throughout the state. The hardest day for fathers who have to shoulder the coffin of their young aeons. The darkest day for mothers who have to see the dead bodies of their children covered with dirt and dust and sweat and blood. But international community is silent. You remain silent. You remain silent. Everyone was silent. I cannot exactly remember the timing of first bomb blast. I cannot exactly remember when first bullet entered into the chest of our hero Burhan Wani, but whom I can clearly and really remember is Irfan, who got 8 bullets on his face from returning from school. Whom I can clearly and really remember is Siraj, who got 8 bullets on his chest while returning from school. Whom I can clearly and really remember is Jawad, whose body shattered into pieces along with his dreams, goals, passions and ambitions. But again, international community is silent. You remain silent and you remain silent. Everyone was silent. Then my lord, allow me. Allow me to lift the lantern of marvelous dignity and immense respect for those heroes of the nation who are killed without any reason, who are slaughtered without any crime, and forgive me. Forgive me for today, that today I will ask questions. Question that will hurt your blissful stumbles for all eternity. That people got killed in 9/11, international community violent. People are getting killed in Palestine, international community silent. 4 people were killed in Brussels, international community violent. More than 50,000 people were killed in Burma, international community silent. 8 people were killed in Germany, international community violent. My whole nation is getting killed in Kashmir. Why the international community is silent? Why the international community is silent? My land, the fact is that when it comes to my land, when it comes to my people, when it comes to Kashmir, I see international community as a calm sea having no eruptions in it. I can take 100 of examples from history, Palestine, Burma, Jordan, Iraq, all around the globe, that no one stands for us. India fights, kills people and steps back. Here we are watching Bollywood stuff. Can't we pressure the international community for an explicit decision of Kashmir? Yes, we can. But in that capacity, we have to struggle, and I will struggle, because struggle is me. Struggle is you. Struggle is history. Struggle is Kashmir. Struggle is Kashmir. My lord, I will stand in the honor of 1,08,804 killed people, more than 10,000 disappeared, 3,732 raped women, more than 4,000 Pakistani army soldiers killed. I will stand in their honor, cause I am the son of the nation, son of the sun, from the land of Mardars, from the land of Ghazis, from the valley of Jahazis, from the land of Pak and pure people, from the land of Pakistan. From the land of Pakistan. In the last, my lord, forgive me. Forgive me for today, that today I am scared. Scared of dreams, dreams that haunt my nights. I cannot sleep properly. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to visualize what I see in my dreams. I see a young Kashmiri child standing in a street. Street with dreary smell. Street with tarnished smell and burning houses. In front of him, I see an Indian tank. The child stares at the tank and says, "Give me freedom or give me death." The tank starts to move. This time the child stands firm like a wall and shouts louder, "Give me freedom or give me death." The tank moves more closer. This time the child picks up the stone, throws it onto the tank and shouts louder, "Give me freedom or give me death." The tank finally stops in front of him. The tank finally stops in front of him, and a sound is heard, boom. Now I can see an 8-inch hole made into the chest of the child by the cannon fired from the tank. His blood read the statement that Pakistan is Kashmir. Kashmir is Pakistan, and we want freedom. We want freedom. We want freedom. We want freedom. Thank you for listening. Thank you all. Thank you.
Last speaker of this contest is Ms. Zulnash Muqaddis from Women University Bagh. Ms. Zulnash Muqaddis from Women University Bagh.